Hello friends, welcome to our channel. Friends, today we will see multiple choice question of civil procedure code. Friends, watch our complete video, like it, share it, comment on it. Don't forget to subscribe our channel. So friends, we will see civil procedure code MCQ. Question number 1. On production of a certified copy of the foreign judgment, the presumption as to the competency of the court under section 14 of CPC is a, answer is rebuttable presumption of law. Question number 2. Under section 13 of CPC, a foreign judgment can be challenged on the ground of, answer is all the above, means option number A, competency of the court pronouncing the judgment. Option number B, being obtained by fraud. Option number C, sustaining a claim founded on a breach of law imposed in India. Question number 3, how many grounds of attack the foreign judgment have been provided under section 13 of CPC? Answer is 6 grounds. Question number 4, on the ground of jurisdiction under section 13 of CPC. Answer is both judgment in personam and judgment in rem can be challenged. Question number 5. Under section 15 of CPC, every suit shall be instituted in, answer is the court of the lowest grade. Question number 6. Section 15 of CPC lays down, answer is a rule of procedure. Question number 7. Under section 16 of CPC, a suit relating to immovable property can be filed in a court within whose local jurisdiction? Answer is the property is situated. Question number 8. Suit in respect of immovable property where the entire relief sought can be obtained through the personal obedience of the defendant can be instituted in a court within whose local jurisdiction? Answer is all the above. Means option number A, the property is situated. Option number B, the defendant voluntarily resides or carries on business. Option number C, the defendant voluntarily resides or personally works for gain. Question number 9. Place of institution of a suit in respect of immovable property situated within the jurisdiction of different courts has been provided. Answer is under section 17 of CPC. Question number 10. Place of suing in respect of suits for compensation for wrongs to person or movable property has been dealt with. Answer is under section 19 of CPC. Question number 11. A suit for compensation for wrong done to the person or to movable property where the wrong was done within the local jurisdiction of one court and the defendant resides within the local limits of another court. Answer is either A or B at the option of the plaintiff. Means option number A, can be instituted in the court within whose local jurisdiction the wrong has been committed. Option number B, can be instituted in the court within whose local jurisdiction the defendant resides. Question number 12. X residing in Delhi publish a statement defamatory to Y in Calcutta. Y can sue X at, answer is either in Delhi or in Calcutta. Question number 13. Suits under section 20 of CPC can be instituted where the cause of action arises. Answer is either wholly or in part. Question number 14. A suit for damages for breach of contract can be filed at a place. answer is both option number A and B. Means option number A, where the contract was made, option number B, where the contract was to be performed or breach occurred. Question number 15. A suit relating to partnership may be instituted at a place. Answer is all the above, means option number A, where the partnership was constituted. Option number B, where the partnership business was carried on. Option number C, where partnership accounts are maintained. Question number 16. A suit relating to partnership dissolved in a foreign country can be filed at a place. Answer is, where the parties to the suit reside in India. Question number 17. In a suit, issues are framed in the respect of. Answer is all the above, means option number A, question of fact, option number B, question of law, option number C, mixed, question of fact and law. Question number 18. Issues means, answer is rival contentions of the parties based on their pleadings. Question number 19. Issues are settled in a suit. Answer is under order 14 of CPC. Question number 20. Which of the issues under order 14, rule 2 of CPC can be tried as preliminary issues? Answer is issues of law. Question number 21. Issues of law can be tried as preliminary issues if it relates to. Answer is either A or B, means option number A, the jurisdiction of the court, option number B, a bar to the suit created by any law. Question number 22. Issues can be altered. Answer is under order 14, rule 5 of CPC. Question number 23. Under order 14, rule 5 of CPC. Answer is all the above, means option number A, issues already framed can be amended. Option number B, issues already framed can be struck off. Option number C, additional issues can be framed. Question number 24. List of witnesses must be filed by the parties. Answer is after the framing of issues. Question number 25. Parties must file the list of witnesses within. Answer is 15 days of framing of issues. Question number 26. Court has the power to summon a person who is not called by any party as a witness. Answer is under order 16, rule 14 of CPC. Question number 27. Adjournment can be granted. Answer is under order 17, rule 1 of CPC. Question number 28. When on the day to which the hearing of the suit is adjourned, the parties or any of them fail to appear. Answer is order 17, rule 2 of CPC shall apply. Question number 29. The court under section 89(1) of CPC can refer the dispute for. Answer is arbitration or conciliation or Lok Adalat or mediation. Question number 30. Which of the following deals with the framing of issues in the Code of Civil Procedure? Answer is order 14, rule 1. Question number 31. Bar to further suit is dealt under which of the following in the Code of Civil Procedure? Answer is section 12. Question number 32. Which of the following deals with the transfer of decree in the Code of Civil Procedure? Answer is section 39. Question number 33. Cost for causing delay has been provided under. Answer is section 35B of CPC. Question number 34. Imposition of cost under section 35B of CPC. Answer is directory. Question number 35. Decree holder. Decree holder means answer is either A or B. Means option number A. Any person in whose favor a decree has been passed. Option number B. An order capable of execution has been made. Question number 36. Plea of res judicata. Answer is has to be specifically raised. Question number 37. According to section 27 of CPC, summons to be dependent to be served on such date not beyond. Answer is 30 days from the date of institution of suits. Question number 38. In which of the following cases, cross objection as between correspondents can be permitted? Answer is both option number A and B. Means option number A, the appeal as regard certain parties cannot be disposed of without determining the question between correspondents. Option number B, where the objection are common as against the appellant and correspondent. Question number 39. A resides at Shimla. B resides at Calcutta. And C at Delhi. A, B and C being together at Banaras. B and C make a joint promissory note payable on demand and deliver it to A. A may sue B and C at Banaras. Where the cause of action arose? Answer is either A or B. Means option number A. He may sue them at Calcutta. Where B resides? If the non-resident defendant objects, the suit cannot proceed without the leave of the court. Option number B. He may sue them at Delhi. Where C resides? If the non-resident defendant objects, the suit cannot proceed without the leave of the court. Question number 40. Who shall produce the evidence first? Answer is plaintiff. Question number 41. Ordinarily, the judgment shall be pronounced as provided under Order 20, Rule 1 of CPC within. Answer is 30 to 60 days of hearing. Question number 42. Judgment and decree have been dealt in CPC. Answer is under Order 20. Question number 43. Clerical or arithmetical mistakes in judgment, order, etc. can be corrected. Answer is under section 152 of CPC. Question number 44. Forgetting the clerical or arithmetical mistakes in judgment, etc. corrected the application. Answer is can be made at any time and no limitation period has been prescribed. Question number 45. Under section 34 of IPC, the court can grant interest. Answer is both option number A and option number B. Means option number A, from the date of the suit till the date of decree. Option number B, from the date of the decree till realization. Question number 46. Provision for interest in CPC has been made. Answer is under section 34. Question number 47. Future interest that is from the date of the decree till realization can be awarded under CPC. Answer is 6% per annum. Question number 48. Pendant light interest can be awarded. Answer is on the basis of the agreement between the parties. Question number 49. Which of the following provisions provide for imposition of cost in a civil suit? Answer is all the above. Means option number A, section 35 of CPC. Option number B, section 35A of CPC. Option number C, section 35B of CPC. Question number 50. Cost can be imposed in. Answer is a suit as well as execution proceeding. So friends, thank you.